them shackles off him. Poor sod can't eat proper.
Dunno, not sure I like that. What if he runs for it? He's worth a heap of coin.
Ah, bollocks. Been holding him a week, hasn't tried a thing. Why are you up and bolt now? Matter of fact, got to thinking. What did a sweet, gentle chap like him do to get the Queen of Zericania so riled?
She's a shrew, that's one. Queen and witch in one. Worst of both worlds.
Enough about her. What do you say to one more of your tales? While we toss down some cards.
Ah, why not? And since you mentioned one queen... Year 1267. War hung in the air, its scent palpable. The mighty empire of Nilfgaard stood poised, greedily eyeing the northern realms just across the Yaruga. In light of the threat, the realm sovereigns met in summit. They made declarations, pledged fraternal assistance, forged alliances, and then, in good spirits, dispersed. Among them, me, Queen of the twin realms Lyria and Rivia. Know the name? Heard her beauty extolled? Justly so. Remarkable she was. Not for her graceful exterior, but for her persistence and courage. Where was I? As the Queen and her retinue neared her capital, Count Caldwell appeared. In Meave's absence, the Count was to have helped her son, the youthful Prince Willem, run the Twin Kingdoms. Caldwell had clearly ridden hard. Drops of perspiration dangled from his whiskers, his neck red and chafed from a rough, starched stiff.
Hail, Your Majesty. Delighted to see you in good health. The summit, it ended fruitfully, I hope?
Yes, at its end, letters were exchanged, documents signed, paper. Time will tell of what value. That will suffice as cordialities go, Caldwell. Tell me what's happened, for I sincerely doubt sheer longing prompted you to ride out.
Indeed, Your Grace. Another circumstance inspired me to do so. The strays of Sparla, the bandits. I was attended to during Your Grace's absence. The situation's gotten out of hand, I fear.
Steady, Caldwell. Come now. Deep breath. All right, speak. What has happened? Be precise.
As Your Grace ordained, I set out and was nipping at the bandits' tails for long. We pursued for weeks, until scouts returned, having sighted the strays' camp in the forest near Lockeren. We waited for nightfall, to surprise them as they slept. Alas, it proved a ruse. We found the tents empty. Straw-stuffed dummies around the fire. Soon, we learned that as we waited for the sunset, the strays had snuck away, rounded our positions and ridden to Hawksburn.
I beg your pardon, my lord. The tax collectors. That is where they station.
So the gold? All of it?
It's stolen, your grace. But I shall do all in my power to recover it. This I vow. If it be your grace's wish.
After weeks in the saddle, your grace's wishes are modest. A hot bath and a night's sleep in her own bed. Yet, they shall have to wait. I must look personally to this matter. Your force, Caldwell, I will now command. You, send a herald to Hawksburn. They must prepare for the Queen's arrival. Air the rooms, dust off the porcelain. Make certain they do it. Do you see now, Reynard? I believe I foretold it would be thus. My son wasn't ready in the least to rule an entire country.
I confess, Prince Willem has much to learn yet.
Yes. And very little time.
Bandits riding. Milka, they stretched her over a fire till she told them where she buried her gold.
Rather die than tell him she would. But I know where she kept it. Sit tight. Sketch it out for you.
Count Caldwell rode at the column's head, scanning its flanks with a wary eye that, despite his advanced age, proved very sharp indeed.
Your Majesty! Bandits! There! At the tree line!
The Count's footmen, unaccustomed to escorting their queen, sought to shield her with their bodies and assumed a tight formation to do so. They were promptly knocked aside as Meave charged headlong at the bandits, brandishing her blade and bellowing a ferocious cry.
Attack! Charge!
Attack the Queen? An outrage!
Your Grace, the men await. You must lead to begin the attack.
To reach.
Salt of the earth, they are, Your Grace. They'd follow you into fire. You need simply say the word.
I shall teach you to respect the crown, you dogs!
Look out! Seek cover! We are bombarded!
A lesson in humility coming now.
One bolt's all I need.
The strays took tail and run! Yes! Our victory is assured! Sound the horns! May they sing praises of this triumph for ages!
The battle's not yet done. It is better to conserve our strength. Prepare for a strike that will prove decisive.
Battle formation! Protect the Queen!
Aye.
That bit the white of an eye from half a league away.
Should have listened to me, old lady.
Yeah, yeah!
Give me a target.
Bigger they are, easier they are to target.
I congratulate you on your latest victory, Your Grace. The bandits stood not a chance.
Matters seem indeed to have gotten out of hand, to put it mildly.
Meave said, arms crossed atop her shining breastplate.
They've grown bold. Doubtless after the raid on the manor, the tax collectors... I've not heard of an ambush on the high road afore,
Caldwell explained, avoiding his liege's wrathful gaze.
Enough, Caldwell. We must put things right. Come!
The Queen's retinue set out, cavalry in front, infantry and arbalists close behind, and, following in the rear, the bandits, bound in chains.
Ah, I do adore this prospect.
Yes, Lyria, the Pearl of the North. With its hills and dales, why, its beauty matched only by that of its queen.
After 3 weeks in the saddle, I've my doubts, Count. We shall pitch camp here. Our soldiers need respite. A spell of it they deserve.
Yeah.
Yes.
A bit of respite, Reynard?
Yes. But if you've any new orders, Your Grace, I can be ready at any...
At ease, Reynard. At ease. Don't you find it wearisome sitting alone? Wouldn't you prefer another's company? Swapping tales with the innkeep, even?
Your concern, I most appreciate, Your Grace. But I prefer silence.
Has it always been thus with you? Ever a man apart?
Quite the contrary, Your Grace. As a youth, I gloried in company, delighted in conversation.
So what was it that changed you?
That delight nearly cost me my head. But do you truly not know the tale, m'lady? How I came to be your departed husband's aide?
I don't, but would gladly hear it.
I had but 20 winters behind me when I enlisted. Yet I was granted the rank of lieutenant from the start, not by merit, but by birth. The respect of veteran officers, both my peers and seniors, that they could not grant. Nor did I deserve it. To earn that respect became my driving aim, and to seem wise beyond my years, I began spouting off about the king's decisions. This maneuver Reginald botched, that he failed to think through, and yet elsewhere he'd blundered like a schoolboy.
Well, a brilliant strategist Reginald was not. They dubbed him the courageous, not the cunning, for good reason, I dare say.
It was not long before I was clanking about in shackles. Another officer had reported me. I was charged with lese majesty. The court-martial took but a quarter of an hour to deliver verdict and sentence. I was guilty of treason, and the noose awaited me. But Reginald first stayed the execution, then ordered that I repeat every word I'd uttered about his person or deeds. Soaked with sweat, my voice cracking, I did as he ordained. Reginald listened, raptly and silently. And when I'd finished, he declared I was right. He then appointed me his personal aide. A clever lad like you, I can always use at my side.
Indeed. Though hardly sharp himself, wisdom in others Reginald both recognized and heeded.
It was then I swore two things. Firstly, never again to wag my tongue like a fool. Secondly, never to betray his trust.
And you never did. Know what he told me moments before he passed. Trust none of them, Meave. Save Reynard. The old sod was right about that, at least. I thank you for sharing that tale, Reynard. Truly. Alas, I've come to fear a villain might simply not be cut out to be a king, let alone a good one.
A harsh judgment, Your Grace. Let's not be hasty. The prince is but 16 summers to him.
And is thus fully grown. The crown he should be able to bear at his age. Yet I left the land in his care for but a few months, and look what's become of it. Bandits roam and loot unchecked.
We might yet learn of mitigating circumstances. Events beyond his control.
Would that it were so, Reynard. Would that it were so. Elsewise, we must hope Anseus will demonstrate more wit than his brother. Though I see little chance of that, either. It's time I attended to other matters.
I pay taxes for, to be robbed along the high road, and in broad daylight, no less. Were it not for mandatory merchant routes and stacking rights, why, I'd have gone round, through Sodden. They told me, Lyria's a wild land, lawless, chaotic, a damn disgrace. Were it not for mandatory merchant routes and stacking rights, why, I'd have gone round, through Sodden.
Gods of mercy! Whatever is this filth?
Necrophages. Drawn here by blood's scent.
For such vile monstrosities to prowl the high roads of my realm, I won't allow it. Attack!
Heat positively sweltering. Have we to do with some manner of sorcery?
We shouldn't exclude the possibility, my lord. And great caution we must exercise.
Rayleigh, what is this? Some spectre? A strigger?
I can't be sure, Your Grace. It's the first I've seen of any such thing.
Arbalist, to your command.
I know them. Appeared on my estate last spring, enticed by the corpses of those of my sheep that fell. Harmless at first. Until, that is, they fill their guts. Seem to become quite powerful then.
They look true, but they bleed just as we do. Onward! Slay the filth!
Aye.
Ah! So fortunate we routed the beasts before they had a chance to gorge.
Should have listened to me, old lady.
Your Grace, yet more come.
They fill their bellies, ma'am. This doesn't bode well. Oh, no. Not well at all.
I'm a warrior.
Thank you.
strong as steers they've grown. And they show no fear.
Frenzied, my lady. It's bloodlust. They lose all instinct to survive, feel no pain whatever. I've witnessed this before.
Your Majesty, we must give ground. Fall back. We can't win. Must minimize our losses. My Queen, there is no shame in ceding the field when fortunes turn sour.
Hours now. We shall not retreat. Arms at the ready. Attack! Look there. Yet another abomination.
That stench. My salts. Where are my salts?
Her Majesty is exceptional. Beasts hadn't a chance against us. Victory is ours.
Many trees we felled, m'lady. Might you have need of them? So, take whatever your heart desires. They call themselves strays? Well, we'll treat them like strays. We build a bridge, brick by brick. A one, a two, the pillar grows thick. Twin there no bandits here. Not surprising, neither, for we'd chase them off with our hatchets, we would. They call themselves strays? Well, we'll treat them like strays.
Seen them? They've fangs, snouts, horns, like a right proper nightmare. Your Majesty, I beg of you, thrash them bandits, please. Scared to step out into me own fields, I am. To raise an hand against the Queen? These hounds hold nothing sacred. Thank you for listening to this tired bag of bones. Folk haven't lent an ear to old Poppy in a long while. Please take this for the road. Your Majesty, I beg of you, thrash them bandits.
Soon, Queen and retinue arrived at Hawksburn. The men stationed there they found standing at attention, baking under the blistering noonday sun.
Your Majesty, Count Caldwell.
Stand at ease, Sergeant. And report.
The local peasants we've rounded up in the yard, Your Grace. Expect they might have lent the bandits aid. Yet our courtesy ain't inspired them. They haven't peeped a word. Might it please Your Grace to summon the hangman? He ties a noose for them, should have them jabbering right quick.
I'll speak to them first.
Your Majesty, for the Queen to question commoners, why, it's simply not proper.
Whom for? I shan't be stripped of crown and titles for it, so no impediment do I see. Lead me to them.
Bow low for your sovereign, Her Majesty, Queen Meave of Lyria and Rivia.
Have mercy, Your Grace. We bear no guilt, we simple folk.
Calm your hearts, good folk. Though your queen I may be, you are subjects, not slaves.
Meave extended a hand, the royal ring gleaming upon it. Unfamiliar with protocol, a pleb gripped it firmly and gave it a shake as hearty as a good scrub in the tub.
My, we shall be addressing one another by name afore long.
This is an outrage! Guards, grab him!
I've all in hand, Caldwell.
Forgive me, Your Grace. I'm not accustomed, nohow.
Nonsense. You've a firm grip, a spry handshake, and a bold spirit I can respect. What do they call you, man?
Helmer, son of Florence.
Delighted, Helmer. Now understand me, man. I am in dire straits and in need of your aid. So please, answer my queries in full and forthrightly. The bandits, whom do they follow?
Him, m'lady. We've seen him. No name, just an odd title. The Duke of Dogs, they call him.
My, a blue-blood thoroughbred mutt. Where are he and his hounds bound? Did he say?
That recall, Imogen? What did he name? A Gleaton or something?
Clayton. Lord Clayton. His estate lies to the south.
Sound the horns. Have the men form up. We march at once.
Milady, I'll be no ire for the Duke. He's a good man. Gave us proper brass for the welcome we gave him. Shared what grub he had.
Shut it, louts. The Queen's had her say. Your Grace, your orders. What are we to do with them?
The Duke of Dogs fed you, so you've strength enough to carry arms. And as he gave you coin, you've no need of pay from the realm's coffers. Sergeant, all men of 15 summers or more will join our ranks at once. They'll serve 5 years.
No, my lady. No. Tis mere weeks to harvest. Who'll tend to fields?
Meave set off toward Lord Clayton's estate at a gallop, her mount knocking the peasants aside as it kicked up a cloud of dust. The folk of Hawksburn spoke of the royal visit long after, albeit ever behind closed doors and in hushed tones.
What is this, Reynard? Rumble. What is it?
Look out! Rock slide! Yourselves!
Your Grace, the wagon, we can use it as cover. Forward, we must move it forward.
What now?
You're far fewer than I presumed. Summon your comrades, dammit! Chop chop, before I reach for my whip.
Give me a target.
The wagon! Use the wagon now!
Oh. We've come through, Reynard. I thank you.
The walls of the temple collapsed. The buttress is doubtless damaged by something.
Or someone. There's nought we can do here.
Thank you.
A peasant cart, loaded with a heap of hay, came rattling down the road from the opposite direction.
Clear the road!
Bellowed Count Caldwell, standing in his stirrups.
Make way for your queen!
The peasants obediently turned their cart into the roadside nettles. As she passed, Meave glanced towards it and froze. Atop the hay bale lay a badly wounded man gripped by fever. The thick, sweet stench of rot wafted from his bandaged legs.
Gods! Who did this to him?
Meave asked.
Bandits?
Nay, milady,
replied the cartman.
"'Twere a beast. Out to the east, down Wetterton way, lies a barnyard, old as the elves, they say.
The peasant continued.
Clayton was set in snares round about there. Came running back to us, drenched in blood, rattling on about a long-haired wench come climbing out a grave. We've taken him to the good sisters of Melitele here on bridge. Perhaps they can help him.
I'm certain they can. And will.
Replied the queen. Though just looking at the wounded wretch, she knew he'd expire before nightfall.
God speed you on your journey.
The queen whistled, and her mare resumed its trot.
Shall I send for a witcher, your grace?
Caldwell asked.
One of those freaks should make short work of the monster.
Until we apprehend the bandits, I shan't allow a single soul to leave our company, even on such an important mission as finding a witcher.
Meave replied.
Any who did would be captured at once. But, if fate brings us near Wetterton, perhaps we'll see to this monstrous harridan ourselves.
Your grace, we've only just fought beasts and scarcely escaped with our lives. This she-beast will take a silver sword. Magic formulae.
Yet a dozen arbalists will have to suffice.
The queen said, calmly but firmly.
And please, Caldwell, do stiffen your spine a bit. Now onward.
Off to Wetterton, are ye? Bonny tune, that. Just the folk could be on shite. Off to Wetterton, are ye? Off to Wetterton, are ye?
The Lyrians entered the graveyard. Crickets chirped in its tall, windswept grass, and lush green moss covered its crumbling gravestones. Only a fresh bloodstain upon a mausoleum wall suggested that something disturbed the dead in their rest and hunted the living.
Save your tears! Throw off your grief!
An eerie voice sang, its ghastly lament standing Meave's hair on end.
Soon your life too shall cease. As you pass into the eternal gloom.
A pockmarked, pustule-ridden creature crawled out from behind some gravestones. It vaguely resembled a shriveled, hunchbacked hag, until its head split into two halves, forming a tooth-spiked maw.
Attack! Everyone!